Not sure who your daddy is? A lot of people don't know who their daddy is. But I want to let you know who's your daddy. You know, I'm going to go to the scripture now, and we're going to go over to St. John, the 8th chapter, 42nd verse. But first, before we go there, we're going to go to the 40th verse. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all of these things shall be added unto you. Dropping down to the 42nd verse, Jesus said unto them, if God were your father, ye would love me. That's an attribute. For I came from God, not of myself, but he sent me. He knew who his daddy was. Ye are of your father, the devil, and the lust of your father ye will do. So you're going to do whatever your daddy do. Because old saying go, children learn what they live. Who's your daddy? Whose child are you? Matthew the 6th chapter and the 24th verse says, no man can serve two masters. For either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve two masters. And when I start thinking about this, I start thinking about people trying to determine who their daddy is. You know, you have to sometimes know about the DNA. You have to take paternity tests sometimes. Sometimes you just have to know little traits and attributes that you have to look for. And this is what God is talking about. If you belong to Sam, something about you gonna look like Sam. If you belong to Nelly, something about you gonna act like Nelly, talk like Nelly. Something gonna make you walk like Nelly and act like Sam. But you know what? God has an all way of he, the way he is. He's the same way. He's our daddy too. On the spiritual side, we have to have a daddy. We have to know that in order to get to that daddy, certain things have to happen. Most people don't like to go to church because, you know, that's kind of like a rest day. And what we want to do is just get up and do our thing and relax. We've worked all week long and we've done everything we wanted to do. But the thing about it, when Sunday comes, we look at it like, I'm tired. When he gave you all those other 7 days a week, 24 hours in a day, to do everything you wanted to do. So when your daddy says, get up and let's go, you rebel. Who's your daddy? He just said, your daddy is the devil. Well, I don't want that to be me. I want to be named among Jesus, my God, being my daddy. So we go on to talk about when we get up and get ready for church sometime, we can get a sudden headache, got to do the laundry, got to go wash our car, just any old kind of thing. Maybe we even going to go out for a barbecue. We're going to do something to be contrary to what we should be doing on a Sunday morning. Just straight down, I'm tired. When only God gave you the breath. And if it wasn't for him, you couldn't even stand up and walk, you couldn't talk, you couldn't eat, you couldn't do anything. Just for that gratitude, we ought to be getting up and running for the Lord and doing everything that we should do. You know, it's really funny when we think about, let's imagine going on a trip. Let's imagine that we're going to meet our daddy for the first time. And we never, now this is a natural daddy. But we're going to meet our daddy for the first time. And my mother, she's told me all about my dad, but I you know, they divorced at a young age, and I just never got a chance to meet my daddy. So we going on a trip, and I'm getting all ready. I'm making preparations, you know, and I start thinking about it. I've got to be prepared for my daddy. And I know that when I look at the way things go, I want God to be pleased with my life, so I want my daddy to also be pleased with my life. In this preparation, I begin to make a checklist. In my checklist, I have to get my suitcase ready and start putting all of my little clothes and get my shoes and my toothbrush ready and all these little odds and ends. And no matter what, I'm anticipating this arrival, this meeting that I'm going to take place, that's going to take place with my dad. So I'm going and I'm getting ready. I'm getting on the road now. I'm starting to drive, but before I get out on the road, I got to do another checklist because I don't want anything to happen. That's no breakdowns, nothing to happen to cause me not to get to my daddy, because that's how bad I want to see him, how much I want to meet him. I've heard all about him. Now it's my turn to see my daddy. So I'm going to fill my tank up. I'm going to check my tires. I'm going to do all kind of maintenance. And I'm going to do everything I can so I don't have any breakdowns or any problems on the road to get to my daddy. You know what? Making it to my real daddy is going to be very important to me. So I've got to do everything to make that happen. Nothing will stop me from making it. Nothing. I'm getting ready. I'm staying ready. I'm staying focused. Never met him, and I'm getting a chance to meet him for the first time. But now I'm there. But two men are standing there waiting to greet me. Oh my goodness, I'm disturbed now. Who's my daddy? Which one of these guys are my daddy? Oh my goodness, I don't want to run up to the wrong daddy. But then this is the same way it is in the spiritual thing. Sometimes Satan will put that masquerade in front of us and make us think, this is our daddy. No, this is your daddy. No, that's your daddy. No, this is your daddy. Who's your daddy? You better know who your daddy is. You better know who your daddy is. So as I began to stand up there and look, start looking at all the attributes, I said, the one on the right kind of looked like me. Got my nose. That might be my daddy. Well, he went to walking. He kind of walked like my brother. Oh, my goodness. Maybe that's my daddy. You know, I'm not sure, but I'm looking, trying to determine who's my daddy. Well, the same scenario takes place in a Christian walk when we're getting ready to know Jesus and when we're getting ready to know who our real daddy. We've been adopted into the faith. We've been children that are adopted in the royal priesthood. God knows he's taken us in. We are his children. So we have attributes too. We're going to walk like him. We're going to talk like him. Our speech is going to be like him. We're going to be acting like him. So many things about us are going to be like our father. We're going to be who he is. And if Jesus is God and he is our daddy, we're going to act like Jesus. Hallelujah. When I think about it, it just lets you know that he who you are is who you are. And I begin to think about, if you love me, you will keep my commandments. So if we really love our daddy, we're going to obey what he's telling us. Even in the natural, we obey our parents. If they tell us to do something because we love them, and if we don't do it, they have a way of getting it done. So does God, because he said he chastens who he loves. He'll tear us up, lay us on our back sometime to get our attention. Well, our parents sometime had to put the mighty rod on us to get our attention. But when you think about it, God's got DNA in you and you and you. If you're a part of him, you're going to have a part of his DNA. And that DNA was the blood of Jesus that his son laid down on Calvary. He gave his life for us that we might have a right to the tree of life. We are adopted into the priesthood. I know who my daddy is. Do you know your daddy? Do you know your real daddy? It's time for you to start knowing who your daddy is. Oh my God. I think about over in Revelation, the third chapter and the 20th verse, he said, behold, and if he ain't your daddy, this is when it can happen. Right in this verse, right here, behold, I stand at the door and I knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come in to him and I will sup with him and he with me. Now that's my daddy. Oh, don't stay in sin that you are in. Come on out of it. Join the priesthood. Join the royal family. Jesus is your daddy. And if you haven't made him your daddy today, you can make him your daddy today. He's standing at the door. He's knocking. He's opening with open arms. And over in Hebrew, the third chapter and the 15th verse, it says, harden not your heart. the day you hear my voice, let him in. Don't harden up. Don't be fearful and rebel against God. Who's your daddy? Who is your daddy? Choose ye this day whom you will serve. Choose the right daddy. Go to the right. He look like you. You look like him. He's walking like your brother and walking like your sister. That's your daddy. Run to your daddy. Know who you're running to. God is so good to us. We have to know that we know that we know that our daddy is Jesus Christ. He stood there for us. In between sin and us, there was the devil that was trying to get our minds, our souls, our hearts. He was trying to take us down, but the Lord said no. He went to that cross. He allowed them to nail him in his hands. He allowed them to nail him in the feet, pierce him in the side. But you know what? For all of that, he gave us a right to be his brother. We are our Father's children. Jesus loves you. Won't you accept him today? Won't you just say yes to the Lord? Don't you know the Lord doesn't want anyone to perish? He's your daddy. Jesus is your daddy. I don't know who you've been your daddy or who cares who was your daddy. You got a real daddy, and that's Jesus Christ. Won't you accept him today? This is your time.